When it comes to our next guest, I get every video blocked. I always have to wait a month, so it's going to be no different with this one. And then the record company block it in Russia because of the current situation. They've taken a stance, which I think on anybody's channel, it's a bit of a cheek. Regardless of the situation, what's happening in Ukraine and Russia, there's two sides to every story. And regardless of what we perceive Putin as, he's putting his people through an awful lot of suffering. And I think people should not block music videos. It's not politics. It's a music video. It's just my stance. And I hope UMG, who usually block me for a month on any Kylie song, take note of that. Back to Kylie, where is the feeling? The reason I've gone back to the 90s is because Kylie is somebody pretty awesomely special. And this song was really underrated. It was almost forgotten about, but yet it's one of her most classical videos. It's fast moving, lots of images, but at the same time, it's pure Kylie liquid gold. Now, celebrating 50 years, you know, a 50th in the business of show business still, and continuing to shine and look fabulous, we sometimes need to know what made us so iconic. And that's why I'm going back quite a lot and doing a lot of reactions of songs that people have just forgotten about or didn't know about and thought, wow. So when it comes to this particular song, as always, I give you, because it's a bio channel, a bit of bio about it. Where's the Feeling was by Kylie, taken from her fifth at the time studio album, Kylie Minogue, in 94. The song was written by Will Smarties and Jane Hanna, and the production was handled by Brothers in Rhythm. It was released in 95 as the third and final single from her self-titled album, because in those days, from one album, artists used to only ever release three or four singles, because there was always 9 or 10, and that was it. Commercially, the song did fairly well, peaking in Australia in the top 30 and becoming the top 20 in the United Kingdom. The song has only been performed on the Kylie Fever 2002 tour, where it's featured in the Crying Game medley. And I think it's a pity that it was more or less, as I said, underrated and forgotten about, because you're going to love it. You really are. The song was originally a club hit within A Dream in 93 and was initially planned for the second single from Kylie's An Optimist 94 album. Although it nearly didn't make the album's final cut at all, it was postponed for the release of Put Yourself in My Place. And the single was then scheduled for release in 95, but delayed again until July, where Kylie completed filming on the movie Biodome at the time. Because she is an actress, everybody, as well. The single version was radically remixed, making it almost entirely unrecognizable. And I hated that remix, by the way, from its original album version. And Kylie, along with BIR, wrote additional lyrics for an extended version of the trip-hop influenced single, Where Is the Feeling, BIR soundtrack. The lyrics were an early experiment to help Kylie in finding the courage to write personal material, which she wanted to explore on her next album, Impossible Princess. But the formats were there, we're going back to the original, and it was considered Kylie's least successful single at the time. The music, this was directed by Keir McFarlane, and previously collaborated with Kylie in Put Yourself in My Place. And I'm going to say this for this song that we're about to hear. If this came back as a release, it would be a smash. There's a right time, right place for everything. With Kylie, there's never a wrong time, because she has written some of the best pop music in the world. And putting her own input on her songs, and this single helped, and the people around her at the time, to turn it around, start moving forward, putting her own stamp and her own lyrics in songs, has made Kylie the icon we all adore. But with this song, I was always an icon. Where Is the Feeling? It can only be with Kylie Minogue. No, everybody, didn't that make you happy? And where's the feeling? The feeling's inside, because she always makes me happy. I did Slow Reaction recently. Do check it out. It's attached to this. And she was dry, sunbathing, looking sexy in amongst all those men. And for what it's worth, Kylie, you're one lucky woman. And then she gets the man in there. And apparently it was a swimming pool in Australia where this was filmed. So there you go. But it gave the sea effect, and he's like the male mermaid swimming away, and she's just getting wet, whereas in Slow she was dry and looking sexy. Wet or dry, Kylie, I have to say you've got one of the most beautiful, iconic faces. The lips, the eyes, everything. I can see why Vogue said you were one of the most incredibly beautiful women to photograph. I can, because videos just portray that, even in all the way back 94 to now. Let's get into the very simple lyrics and wrap this up, because we don't want to keep it going. There's nobody better than you, she says. You make me feel happy. Happy, happy to know you, but where is the feeling? The feeling of security. There's no security in a relationship. The only security is within yourself. And I've always said that. If you don't feel secure from the moment you are with this person, then you need to get running and go with your feet and find someone else. Verse 2, when we're not together, tell me everything's going to be all right. It's just no use, can't get over you. Anytime you want me, I can make you happy. I can make you happy. There ain't nothing I wouldn't do to make you happy. I think in these lyrics, it's pretty sad when you think it takes one person to give so much of themselves and say, I'll make you happy, I'll make you happy. It's almost like begging. And I'm glad that since the time this was written, now women today don't beg, they don't run, they don't, if you like me, you want me, tell me, show me. There's none of this mystery about, I can physically make you happy, I'll do anything I can to just tell me. There's none of that anymore. Boys, watch out. Times are tougher these days. You want to prove your love? Prove it. It continues, tell me I'm crazy, maybe since you've gone. They don't understand that together we're one. But where is the feeling? The feeling of security. It continues the theme, doesn't it? Because even in a close relationship, I have to admit, you do feel insecure. For example, if your partner is much more successful than you, you feel insecure. If your partner is more loving than you, and it's not in your nature to be so loving, you feel insecure. You feel, why are they with me? I'm not like him or her. And, you know, insecurity comes in many forms. It's not always financial. It's not always the physical. It's not always about love. It's just about being insecure about yourself. And that's what all the other insecurities feed off. It's like this thing that feeds. So learn to be positive. Learn to turn I cannot into I can. And I love myself into I'm going to love myself more. And you'll be okay. It continues. When we're not together, tell me everything's going to be all right. It's just no use. Can't get over you anytime you want me. And it continues. I can make you happy. All of that. And then it continues. When we're not together, tell me everything's going to be all right. So there's reaffirmation needed almost in these lyrics to say, look, and the reason I think it was done in water is drowning in emotions, feeling like some people feel like lost in a desert, or dry feelings. This time it's just I'm swimming here and floating, but I'm going to drown in my emotions if I don't know which way to turn. I'm lost. I'm like the ship without a sail. Tell me which way to sail. But again, the advice I give today is, if you don't know which way to sail, if you don't know which way to steer yourself, then you will drown. And for good reason, that it's not meant to be. And if you feel insecure, you can't go into any relationship until you're positive about yourself. And that means you have to start learning to love yourself. Simple as that. Then she finishes, I'll make you happy. Oh, yeah, 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 I'll make you happy. There ain't nothing I wouldn't do. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's sad in a way that a lot of people think like that. I'll do anything to make them realize. I will sell my soul, my heart, my... But what you do in the end is you sell your dignity. And what you've got to learn is to give a little. It's like chicken feed. Throw the crumbs, see if they eat away. And that's it. That's all you should have to do. Otherwise, the relationship is physically and mentally draining. And that's not good in anybody. So that's my analysis of Kylie's wonderful, iconic song. I hope you've enjoyed it. I have. I always do with Kylie. It'll probably be blocked, but I hope not, because I want you to get a fresh reaction in 23 to Kylie. We mean as we mean to go on with me reminiscing about her repertoire, and I hope you're enjoying it. If so, comment a like and subscribe. Happy 2023 to you all.